Okay, I will bring us back to the same region, but we'll change our perspective slightly. I'll talk about some aspects in the southeast corner of the Balkan Peninsula, known in some circles at least as Thrace, although others would disagree. In case we have forgotten where we are and what do we perceive as Balkans, especially today, very often we hear or we tend to refer to this area as one unity, with the southern part of it being perceived or perceiving itself as culturally different. But as we all know from the inside, it's an amalgamation of places, people that do not necessarily like each other, routes and connections. And it is also this mosaics of landscape, as we have seen, like from many different parts and presentations so far. So we have these impressive and not that impressive mountain chains cross-cut by river valleys, and all together surrounded by the sea, which must have played some role, at least in some occasions. And not to be deterministic, but rather possibilistic, all these different landscapes kind of predispose different living conditions or different occupation or survival strategies. And that's more or less today, but what was during the late Bronze Age? In many publications, discussions, we do see this sort of map. So without the question mark, but it's always in our heads. So we tend to make some associations between the Eastern Mediterranean and Central Europe, or talk about one region and the other in a broader context, but the map of the Balkans is usually blank. It's not that we don't know or we disagree that certain things were happening there, but we rather don't understand or think that it's something rather wild that we don't tend to address or leave it for the future. Yeah, I'm not going to talk about the entire Balkans, but I'm going to focus on this particular area, which still should be able to put some insights on what was going on. And what do we know about this particular part during the late Bronze Age? One of the excuses for like not having anything out there, again, especially in the regional context, is that there is a sporadic evidence of late Bronze Age, that there is no stratified multi-layered settlements, and everything tends to be associated with the so-called Zenitoplovdiv horizon. So I will put all this to some sort of discussion and test. So the sporadic evidence, it's not that sporadic. So bear with me, the Macedonian sites, they're here only for reference of continuation in the landscape, but only within, let's call it Thrace for now, the sites that have late Bronze Age evidence are about 300. So we have something to deal with. The fact that out of all this material, there is no proper multi-layered settlement, especially in comparison to the settlement maps in Macedonia, probably should force us to ask a different question, not to expect to find this settlement, but why actually we don't have it there. And the Zimnichaplovdiv horizon, so that up top is Danube. Here is the Rhodope Mountains. So there are two particular sites that have very similar material, and based on them, cross-cutting the Balkan Mountains, pretty much the entire area of Bulgaria have been associated with this culture called Zimnichaplovdiv, which is very convenient, like to put a culture within a country, but it's a little bit suspicious, let's put it this way. So this culture, or whatever we decide to call it, it's based entirely on pottery. So one way to question this is to address with the same type of material that has been constructed on, but we're going to back it up or put something like a semi-blunt test with a site distribution. To do that, because there's a lot of pottery and the methodology being spread in between three countries and throughout many years, and with many research agendas, it's very often incomparable. So we have selected some specially sensitive elements in the pottery, which means like nothing that is entirely and only site-specific has been included. And we have chosen some spatial statistics and some techniques borrowed from machine learning in order to try and put as much of the record as it is testable out there. So the strength of the so-called relative risk analysis is that it's not simply distribution maps, so that we could see points of different types of types based on their methodology created by different types of researchers, but it kind of blindly estimates the probability of certain type appearing based on the other types that are distributed in this area. And just some examples of different categories being examined the same way. So we could already see heat maps in different parts of Thrace. These are the contour, and as you can see, we already have a suggestion that this kind of particular type of contour gets distributed throughout a larger area, which might make us ask a particular question: what were the contents of this particular type? Different bowls, different so-called kailikes, and some sort of technological distinction between two types of decoration, not only to be based on shapes, but also to have some other markers. And based on that, so all these relative risk surfaces have been taken together and put into another algorithm that estimates, based on the decision trees, whether there are some sort of clusters of types joined together, let's put them this way. So only on pottery, done this way, we have identified like five different areas. So it's not that people don't usually say like, oh, there is difference between Eastern and Western Rhodope, something different is going on around Struma, but we have never actually put this to a proper test and to see how they're actually different and what these things might mean. And of course, the next question is, could this be diachronic? Like, do we have any chronological patterns there? Until recently, we had very few dates, that radiocarbon dates that we could rely on, but more and more of those have been accumulated. So here, I have modeled all dates throughout the Bronze Age, whatever we have for the Bronze Age itself, and catching a little bit of the Iron Age so that we could diminish the impact of any edge effects. So there are two important points, leaving aside the early Bronze Age. There is this interesting divide between the 17th and the 16th century, which in this case would mark the end of the Middle Bronze Age and the beginning of the Late Bronze Age, or two different things happening, as I will show in a while. And the second thing is that we have this peak in the Late Bronze Age between the 14th, and here it extends towards 1000 BC, but we also have this break in the 1200s, which could be associated with the end of the Late Bronze Age and the beginning of the early Iron Age. And of course, what would that mean spatially? We don't have enough data to actually perform this test, but only this picture suggests that there is like some sort of spatial differentiation that we could examine in a more traditional way currently. So this is our chronology table compared to the rest of the region, mostly Greece, of course. So what we could see is that we do have dates from the Upper Thracian Plain and the Eastern Rhodope that correspond to Middle Bronze Age that is still questionable for Bulgaria, especially what kind of material we do associate with these years. And then in the Upper Thracian Plain and the Eastern Rhodope, we also have the earliest material appearing in the Late Bronze Age, which is exactly around that divided after the end of the 17th century or a little bit earlier. Aegean, Thrace and Macedonia, wherever we could date, also Eastern Macedonia, not going further, also begins more or less there. And Western Rhodope only comes in the 14th century to be followed by the Struma Valley even later, or around that time. So one interesting thing that came out of this analysis is that we were able to associate some of the material that is often related to the Late Bronze Age, but we actually have two data sets. The first one clearly follows an earlier Bronze Age tradition, and it's always, there are not many sites that actually have this material, but they are always associated with an earlier Bronze Age. While these guys here, it's a completely different pottery style, completely different tradition, both technologically and stylistically, that appears at once sometime in the early 16th century. So I'm just going to leave this out here. And then we have applied the same technique, I'm not going to go into details, to the site distribution. Basically we have, as the sites have been published or existing in the Bulgarian repository, ecological map of Bulgaria with their types, some of them are only based on survey material, so we cannot go into further interpretation, but we could see some clear patterns. The upper Thracian plain being compatible with what's happening in the Western Macedonian, Eastern Macedonian, Western Thrace. I'll explain that later. The Eastern Rhodope, which are these orange triangles, these are, besides like the settlement types that we have these particular sanctuaries, which nobody can explain why they're sanctuaries, but they are located on very high peaks and have like material spread around the rocks, but nothing that could really speak of cult. But it is true that these places are only located there. We don't have them in the western part of the Rhodope Mountains, we don't have them in the Balkan Mountain, we don't have them anywhere. And then in the Struma Valley, which are the blue dots there, in this place we have stone architecture with clearly defensive character. And what are these dots in the western Rhodope? Again, I'll go back to these maps. This is the distribution, the sole distribution of tumuli. So going further, based on these areas, I have done also some location modeling in order to see whether there is some sort of association with the landscape and whether there's some hidden choice behind the hidden reason behind the choices of location of each of these settlements, site types. So what came after that is that we have a very similar pattern between, as I said, the Upper Thracian plain and Western Macedonia, which, so speaking about mounds, I mean settlement mounds or tells, but it's not that they have been created during the late Bronze Age. There are earlier prehistoric mounds that have like a very sporadic occupation on top of the late Bronze Age, but it's always there. Almost on every single settlement mound, there's a late Bronze Age and later material. A lower elevation, of course, this is not a high mountain area, but still comparing this particular area and the elevation range that is distributed there, these are particularly low places spread along the large, probably navigable rivers, and there is a strong correlation with limestone and alluvium deposit. And the Struma Valley, on the other hand, the settlements are located in, so these are much steeper hills that one could imagine, but they're only located in 300 to 400 meters hilltops, and they have some sort of association with conglomerate and gneiss and schist, probably construction material for all these fortifications. And in the Rhodope Mountains, as it has been suggested many times, the western part is much different than the eastern part, both geographically and culturally. So the eastern Rhodope being this friendly environment, everybody would love to live there, I would love to live there. And then in the western Rhodope we have these steep gorges that is again very beautiful, but it's not a, a dream place to live, probably, for some. And these are, this one example of the so-called rock sanctuaries, sorry, rock sanctuaries, which is the most typical part of the Eastern Rhodope, one of the typical things. And in the Western Rhodope, we have the tumuli, and we don't have settlements. We just have the tumuli. And not only we have the tumuli, but they appear first everywhere. Most of the tumuli in the Western Rhodope are late Bronze Age. They come with cremation, which does not exist otherwise, like it appears for the first time. We have the rest of the known cemeteries from the late Bronze Age are in the Upper Thracian plain, and they're flat cemeteries, mostly with inhumations, and we have occasional cremation here and there, probably migrants. So this is the ritual, it's an example, but this pottery is not from there, just that I couldn't find in the last moment something to present the ritual itself. So this is a Parachin pottery, but so with the burial mounds, with the cremation comes this specific burial ritual. So it's an urn, it's a covered with a vessel, and it's accompanied by two or three smaller vessels. Every single burial mound behaves this way. And so, what is the general picture? In the Western Rhodope, we have only the burial mounds. They do have some sort of association with a bedrock, but we don't know what's hidden in there. They are almost always located on a low slope and possibly located on ridges. So this is not just by observation, this is these are the results from the locational analysis. In the Eastern Rhodope, we could identify three different categories which exhibit different behavior. So the settlements are again on ridges, but they are also with a particular distance to running water. So it's usually more than 1 kilometer. And this is very different from what we find in the upper Thracian plain, which is clearly something that needed to be close to the rivers. They like these rivers, they want to do agriculture and whatnot, while these guys were doing something else. And the elevation here, unlike the Struma Valley, which was 300 to 400 meters, here is 400 to 500 meters. And it's not that significant that it's different from Struma, but it's more significant that these sanctuaries actually did prefer the higher peaks for one reason or another. Again, I cannot say that they are actual sanctuaries, but they are different occupation places. They are always on peaks. They are very close to running water. So under every single peak that they chose, there is running water underneath, surrounding the peak. And there is a strong association with limestone or marble. So in this kind of analysis, we only get the correlation, but that doesn't mean that the places were located there because of the limestone or the marble, but probably it has something to do with the actual mining activities. So this might be one of those hidden connections that we only see as association, but we don't know what it means exactly. The cemetery type, so some people speculate with dolmens and sizeable graves, which is not entirely impossible, but we don't have enough evidence actually to say that they were built during the late Bronze Age, and there is a strong association with those locations, gneiss and schist, because they were simply built of that material. Sorry, am I out of time? I know I'm here, that's why I'm shaking. Just a simple picture in the Upper Thracian Plain and the North Aegean hinterland, we're probably dealing with shifting agriculture. Why? Just because we don't have the multi-layered settlements, but we have an occupation throughout about 4 centuries. So they're probably moving from a place to a place rather than sitting in one particular place. In the eastern Rhodope mountain, we have probably seasonal settlements, specialized craftsmanship, as the Adatepe mine can suggest, based on localized resources. In western Rhodope, we have a strong evidence for mobility and some foreign burial customs appearing. And in the Struma Valley, we have a system of defensive settlements. So they were protecting themselves from something. And just as a summary, that pottery that appeared in the 16th century has nothing to do with the previous Middle Bronze Age and Early Bronze Age tradition, but it has ancestors in the Middle Bronze Age of the Hungarian Plain and the Carpathian Basin. So I'm not saying that they necessarily moved together at this particular point, but that's where we could trace the pottery tradition coming from. 15th and 14th century, we do have these mosaics of different things going on with a little bit of a connection, let's say, to the Danube River. In the 14th century, something that is typical for the lower Morava with the Bernica culture and probably even further north infiltrates the western Rhodope mountain. To finish with again a full picture and the only association with Zimnica-Plovdiv horizon actually is a pottery typical for a cosmogenic culture which is in the northeastern part of the area, which eventually connects to the upper Thracian plain. Thank you.